I mean, we were just chatting outside and I realized I had to change all the questions because of some things which I didn't know. Well, I just want to start on some observations. I think this film I really like, I admire this film because it's really like that no fixed contours, you know. It's yeah. really that piece of work. So I feel if you analyze it, I somehow will taint it or, you know, I feel that process of breaking it apart. I feel, you know, it might not be necessary because it's very amorphous. And then also I find that in that sequence with the on the boat, where they're reading about Apte's criticism on Phalke, but slowly it kind of fades off. And you show that there's a more important thing happening, which is that the boy is sleeping. And perhaps
means a sequence of signs. Did before that also, I did a documentary called Phalke Children about Phalke in Bihar and Bombay and Baroda. So I said, you know, like these students were writing stories. So my theory was that story is a means of storing information. It's when there's so much information and it keeps accumulating and there's no space to keep the store this information. So what are the means of storing information? So like say iconography, you know, that is also a means of storing information. So if I deconstruct an icon, I can retrieve all the information that went into making that icon. Similarly, it was about the story. So I had done, but I hadn't covered Banaras. We didn't have the money for that. So in 2012, I approached FD and they said, we'll fund you to edit the material you had. So we came out with 7 short films, 1 hour each, about the Phalke in every city, Kolhapur, Nasik, Pune, Yevo. Now Banaras is very dramatic, you know, because one image that I retain in my mind is that the Phalke his one son dies, you know, and his one son dies, and they go for his funeral, and he is heartbroken, Phalke, because he is almost at the state of Raja Harichandra himself, so. He is very angry and sad. So when his children come, let's go home. And he is doing rehearsal for his play called Rangbhoomi. So he gets very angry. So what he does, that he tears his dhoti and burns it. And he throws this ashes. He keeps his 5 children together. And he makes a circle around them through ashes and says, you are dead for me, you know. So this way we are... okay, looking for where Phalke lived. That is the only thing. And these information about these events like Mandakini falling from a swing, one girl breaks her,
this, you know, how as a team to be aware, like, you know, like chance, like, you know, you're talking about Phalke and Gandhi when he...
She feels guilty, stealing roses in a garden, or...
Later in the archive, you find... so many, this, as they say, it's such a coincidence.
Sister, it won't be coincidence because what happened that, see, the information is scattered, but when you are looking for them, and you, in a ritual, what happens in a ritual, that you create a microcosm, you know, of all the signs, and you put them in, you know, somewhere together, means you are actually compressing the spaces, and they come together, and they link with each other, you know. Now, if I'm looking for, I mean, when I'm looking, researching Phalke, Tilak is there, you know. I mean, Tilak died in 1920. He would be there. I know that I'll find him. Because since, if I'm receiving him during my research, it means he was there, you know. So for that, you know, like, I'm very confident that whatever I am looking for, and if I'm going, if my ritualistic process is correct and I haven't made any mistake, so I'll keep perfecting what my intention is and what I'm looking for, you know. I'll keep perfecting. But if the sequence of the gesture is not right, or say if the Srishti wasn't there, it would have been something else, you know. Or if, say, Hansa wasn't there, it would have been something else, you know. If that boy wasn't there, it would have been something else. So, you can say the desire and the nature helps the seeker.
Okay. So, it somehow kind of you materializes. You find things.
And, of course, you have to will it also, you know. But in this, since I have been at it for such a long time, so Banaras was quite effortless for me, you know. I mean, it wasn't a very painful kind of exercises. In these kind of a desiring and ritualistic processes, sometimes it has been painful. Sometimes it doesn't work, and it actually affects you physically, you know. But this was effortless, you know. I was quite confident, you know.
I mean, I think because that process which we were talking about, that has taken so many years to kind of, you know, get around. One thing is that, say, history and myth, and we go on discussing in academia or whatever, that a certain Indian sense of historicity, you know, that sense of time, you know, there's discussions. But to actually capture it live, you know, the way you have done it, I think is something really wonderful, because even let's say, it's a process of telling stories, remembering, forgetting. Like, for example, those two boys, you maybe told them the story,
yes,
and they had to.
But
recollect.
I know it, because I'm looking for that emotional equivalent to the image, which is a memory about these two boys, and one loses his way, and when they come back, one of the brothers is dead. That I know, but I'm looking for it. So now I have to see, am I going to stage it, or am I going to find an image where this exactly two brothers like that are walking the stage? To stage it, I'll think that aesthetically it's not that good, you know, because I hate directing actors that you cry, you feel sad, you love falana person, you shed tears. I just hate directing or telling people to do this and do that, you know. So this was more easy because I was the actor and I was telling the story. Now visually, I have some guideline with me that, okay, I'm talking about cinema, I'm talking about curtains, I'm talking about plays, I'm talking about, the play means the streets are, Banaras streets are stages, you know, they are theatrical spaces. Or I will think that that the time when you have those cameras, which are box cameras, or you have camera obscuras, so the images are inverted images when you look through the viewfinder. So I will be using that method that, okay, you have a theater, and when the same thing is looked through the box camera, the images are inverted. So I have this too. So when you have an ordinary image, and I will apply, say, theater shot through the box camera mirror. So you get these inverted images, like these two boys walking in the street, you know. And you have these inverted images when the boy is drowning also. That image of this boy is shot through the inverted image. Or that boat, or when he's drowning and the boatmen are trying to pull him. So that is also, you know, inverted image. So I'll say, okay, what technology, what kind of a level of technology is operating at that time? Because they also are sign of that time. So I'll say, okay, this is the printing technology, this is the level, you know. Because I treat technology also as, say, stages of different embryonic growth, you know. Like, I'll say the embryonic growth never stops, you know. We are still in a state of embryonic growth. we are not born or come out of the womb still, you know. So I mean, these are my presumptions for my delusions, you know. I mean, it doesn't apply to anybody or to academics also. So these are my delusions, you know.
I think we have some 5 minutes, yeah. I mean, one clear thing is this theatre versus cinema in this piece. And in the end sequence, when you project the film on the screen and on the ghats, at the beginning, there's somebody doing the aarti. There's a purohit in the corner.
Hmm.
He's doing the aarti. It's kind of a veneration starting.
Yeah. Okay.
And then the same fire burns the screen
okay.
up. And is there some, I mean, what, because
okay,
it's
I. Hmm. So I'll take, okay, these are the symbols and so many amount of symbols and signs. First thing is, that is the year where it is 100 years of Indian cinema. Okay, the first film is Raja Harichandra. So this is the Harichandra Ghat. So I get this, you know, this is the information. Now I'll have to create all these information. I'll have to create a ritual from all these information. Means, so the ritual will be, I am going to screen Raja Harichandra film at the Raja Harichandra Ghat. And I am going to make it a public event. I am going to invite the people of Banaras to come and watch. You know, this is the opening desire of so. So once this desire is put in, now I'll say, okay, what are the other elements operating there? I'll say, okay, Kamal, you are thinking the camera curtains or are bed sheets, you know. Okay. You were saying they are veils. Okay, you were saying they are shrouds. Or you were saying they are shrouds, you know. Or that is a shroud, or it is the sadi of that the Taramati, which she tears and gives the shroud as a tax, half the shroud. So, okay, it's an entertainment tax, you know, the piece of cloth. So, I'm putting all these elements together to build my ritual. Now the cameraman also understands that he is only going to record the building of that ritual. And since the ritual is shot in a temporality, because it's progressing, one sign, second sign, third gesture, fifth gesture, or even when this, I'm reading that dream from Raja Harichandra, that is it a dream or is it a reality? So the king says, even if in the dream I have given up my kingdom, there's no difference between the. So I'm sitting there. Now I was waiting for that moment because I saw that there is this man, like a Raja Harichandra, in his chandal vesh, stripped of all the cloths. He is burning there, kapadas and lakadi in. And I had made friends with the Goswami, other woman, who was also given up. So I know and I, coolly slip and sit there and start reading the same chapter. I kept that chapter in my mind all then. I'm looking for a location. Whenever I'll come at the right location, I'll read. So, what I see, I'll see it as a narrative painting, which is scrolling in, opening in time, but says, now, sir, you have, 100 years of Indian cinema, you have dream and reality. Now, I'm adding my fiction, but, and there is an actuality, which may be a virtuality, because Banaras is a virtual city, It must have been actual at one point, Now there is a constant dialectics of the virtual and the actual. So I'm also adding, my elements there, my fiction there. And it is when it is blending with so-called actual virtual of the real space, it is transforming it, So that transformation becomes a reality and the camera guy or we are documenting it, So, because the principle is again that I use this principle. Suppose there is a real city or an actuality, Now I enforce my fiction upon it, you know. So it's a foreign object, my fiction. So the actual or the nature will reject it, you know. But the fiction will impose itself. And there will be a certain kind of a breakdown. So there will be my fiction that which is I'm imposing will get affected and get transformed, and similarly the actual or the nature will get transformed because of this collision, you know. That breakdown is the documentation that I do, you know.
Thank you. We have some questions.
I have the feeling that every one of your films is better than the last one. I see a progression in your films. And having seen Pushkar Puran, I understand this film more. This is the second time I've seen Rangbhoomi. But I'm a little uncertain about the end and about the end of Phalke. I'm wondering if the play Rangbhoomi was actually performed. And I'm also wondering, I don't know that much about the end. I don't know anything about the end of Phalke's career after Banaras. Did he return to cinema?
Who? Phalke?
He did. Yes.
Yeah. Not very successfully, but he made one very big film. One film is called Setu Bandhan, which is exactly at the time of when silent cinema was shifting to the talkie. And the one film he made, Ganga Avataran, very big film. But as he was becoming old and not being able to cope with the technology, he was becoming more and more megalomaniac, you know. So in his old age, when he had lost his memory, he was planning a 3D film, you know.
Uh-huh. And was Rangbhoomi performed in Banaras?
Yes.
It was?
Yes.
It's not really a question. I just wanted to say how much I enjoyed watching it again. I've, like several of us here, I've seen it many times, and I remember the first time we showed it at that Badami single screen theater when we had a conversation about how this was actually a film on film. I mean, you were kind of performing the role of a historian. But today, when I watched it, and from what you were saying about this archetypal image, which is determined by some kind of emotional quotient quality. I kind of also struck me that somewhere you're performing the role of an archivist also, because, you know, the archivist takes things out. We don't have a consolidated archive. We have a scattered archive, and that process so beautifully demonstrated. That scene where Hansa encounters those books is just remarkable. But gathering all that material, which is fragile, it will disappear. You're constructing an archive on Phalke, you know, tracing Phalke, the Phalke factory thing. And what is I find quite remarkable about this is that it's actually head-on opposing the idea of the colonial archive, because the colonial archive is based on some kind of fact, and this is reading in this process of imaging, you know, which is like an active process of meaning making. I find that really fascinating, that you're actually kind of it seems to me somehow questioning the whole idea of the archive by constructing an archive, which is a very alternative archive, which interestingly I find in the work of Nalini Malani also, which also, you know, beginning from the 90s. So there is, your project starts in the 90s, but in the arts and film kind of circle among some people, there seems to be this active engagement with the idea of the archive and what does it really mean to bring things out of the archive, but also construct a post-colonial archive in some sense.
Now, this archive as a production center has become very fashionable these days, you know. Since there's so much funding, you know. But this is all the self-funding almost, you know. Kya paisa hota hai? I mean, I've given my life to it, you know, 5 lakhs or 6 lakhs, forget it.
It's a very wonderful film. it is not directly related to film production. In Varanasi, that Manikarnika ghat where Vishwanath temple is there, close to that ghat, there is an archaeological inscription. Here the Lord Vishnu conducted yajna.
Yes.
One thing. Again, another one or two ghats back, then 23 or 24. Here taking a dip in Ganga in this place, one dip is equivalent to taking three dips at Allahabad. Why this archaeological department is probing the history? Why they are praying? It's a fiction, it's a confusing with the common people. They should not have, on what is the basis for that, so statements which they have inscribed there at the God. Your comments, please.
I wouldn't know, I only comment about what I do, you know. Not involved in other people's businesses.
Thank you so much. His Pushkar Puran, Puran screens day after tomorrow, he's here, so do have a conversation with him. We'll just take a 2-minute break. The next film we'll be screening is Portrait of a City by Chidananda Das Gupta, so just hang around here. There's some seats here if people want to move. There's also